I am Dr. Jitin Rajan and today we will discuss how to calculate heart rate and rhythm in ECG. So without going into details of calculation and formula, we will see how to calculate the heart rate and rhythm. Then we will also discuss the clinical importance of heart rate and rhythm in ECG and what's its practical utility. But before going into that, we have to know the normal ECG standardization, how the ECG is normally standardized. Okay, so ECG is read on a grid system. You know that ECG is read on a grid system having small squares and large squares. Without going to detail, let us have a quick revision of the grid system, which is essential for calculating rate and rhythm in ECG. Okay, so this is the normal grid system. The vertical axis in this grid system is the axis for the voltage, the vertical axis. In the vertical axis, two big squares, which is equal to 10 millimeter, is equal to 1 millivolt, which is equal to 1 millivolt in the grid system. So one small column or one small square in the vertical axis will be equal to 0.1 millivolt. The horizontal axis is the speed axis or the time axis, which we are going to use today. So the basics. So the few basic things. First, the speed of the ECG. The speed of the ECG is 25 millimeter per second, and 5 big squares equal to 1 second, or 1 second is equal to 5 big squares. Therefore, one small square on the horizontal axis will be equal to 0.04 seconds. So here is this. So on the horizontal axis, one small square is equal to 0.04 seconds, and on the horizontal axis, the one large square is equal to 0.25 seconds. As 0.5 multiplied by 5 is equal to 0.2 seconds. And 1 second is equal to 5 big square. So 10 seconds. So what would be the 10 seconds? 10 seconds would be 5 into 10, 50 big squares. So 10 seconds. 10 seconds would be equal to 50 big squares. 50 big squares. So remember that, because we will be going to use this thing in calculating the rate and rhythm of ECG. So what to look first, rate or the rhythm? So what to look first, the rate or the rhythm? So usually rate is looked first, followed by the rhythm. So usually in ECG reading, rate is looked first, followed by the rhythm. But I would suggest you to go for rhythm first, followed by rate calculation. So rhythm first, followed by rate calculation. Okay, so first, what is rhythm? So first, what is rhythm? So rhythm means timing of discharge. So rhythm simply means timing of discharge. That is, the timing of each and every discharge from the SA node will be at equal interval or regular interval. That is, the time interval between two discharges will be equal. This is normal and it is called regular interval. If the timing between the discharge from SA node is unequal, it is called irregular. So if the timing between discharges from the SA node is unequal, it is called irregular. Okay, so how to check the regularity or the rhythm? So this is done by using the R waves. This is done by using the R waves. That is, the rhythm is checked by the R wave. Not only the rhythm, the rate is also calculated by using the R wave. So why use the R wave to measure the rate and rhythm? Can't we use the P waves, the T waves? So the answer is yes, we can also calculate by using the P wave and the T wave, but we use R wave because it is more prominent wave, so it would be easy. Plus the shape of the T waves, the shape of the T waves is usually normal, whereas the shape of the P wave and T wave can undergo changes or can be absent, which is less common in R wave. That's why we use R wave. So this is the reason why we use R wave for calculating the rate and rhythm. Okay, So the rhythm or the regularity. So the rhythm is said to be regular. So let's see how to calculate that. So the thing is, so the rhythm is said to be regular if the distance between R and R dash is equal. The distance between R and R dash is equal, then it is said to be regular in rhythm. If the distance between R and R dash is not equal, then the rhythm is said to be irregular. So let's see what does it means. So here we can see the ECG strip consists of R waves, different R waves. So here is the R wave, first R wave. The second R wave we can mark as R dash. The next R wave we can mark as R. The next one as R dash. You can simply also mark as R. Next R wave as R. So when we measure the number of columns between R and R waves. So here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4. There are total of 4 columns between R and R dash. Next between R dash and R. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 columns. 4 big columns or big squares. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4. So this means the distance between R and R dash waves are equal. So if the distance between R and R dash, here the number of large columns are 4, they are equal among different R waves, then the rhythm is said to be regular. But if in a condition where the distance between different R waves are different, maybe 3, 3.8 or 5 or 6, then if the distance between R and R waves or R and R dash wave is not equal, then the rhythm is said to be irregular. Okay. So if the distance between R and R dash are not equal, then the rhythm is not regular. So here the number of large columns between R and R dash are equal. So then how to write it down? So it can be regular or it can be irregular. So if it is regular, you can simply in your ECG reading, you can write down R R dash or simply R R regular. Or you can write down, just simply write down rhythm regular. R Y T H U M rhythm regular. Or you can simply write it down as R R interval equal or R R dash interval. Interval equal, or you can simply write down R R dash interval regular. So this is how you write down your ECG finding. R R dash regular or rhythm regular or R R dash interval equal or regular. So one thing you have to know that minute variations can be there. Okay, here there is 4, but minute variations can be there. It can be 4.2, 4.3, 4.5. This is normal variation because heart rate changes during inspiration and expiration. So minute variation can be left out, but usually the rhythm should be equal. That's the thing. So if it is regular, that means heart is beating at regular interval. So if it is regular, that means heart is beating at regular interval and the rhythm is normal or regular. Okay. So what is its clinical significance? So normal rhythm is considered as the sinus rhythm. So what is the sinus rhythm? So very simply, the sinus rhythm means the rhythm of the SA node, that is the rhythm produced by the SA node, and we can say sinus rhythm is regular. If the rhythm is irregular, that means the SA node is discharging at unequal interval. So if the rhythm is irregular, then that means that the SA node is discharging at unequal interval. So all this is based on the assumption that heart rate is equal to the pulse of the patient or the radial pulsation of the patient. So the basic assumption is that heart rate is equal to the pulse of the patient or the radial pulse of the patient, which is usually true. But there are a certain condition in which the heart rate or the beating of the heart is not equal to the pulse rate. But we can leave it as it is very uncommon. Okay, and go to the assumption that heart rate will be equal to the pulse or the peripheral pulse of the patient. And if the rhythm is regular, pulse will also be regular. So if the rhythm is regular, the pulse is regular. If the rhythm is irregular, pulse will be irregular. So then what we have to do? We have to go to the examination section. We have to palpate the peripheral pulse of the patient and look for the type of irregularity. Type of irregularity, whether the pulse is regularly irregular or irregularly irregular. So we know the conditions in which the pulse is irregularly irregular and the condition in which the pulse is regularly irregular. So the pulse is irregularly irregular in case conditions like atrial fibrillation, and the pulse will be regularly irregular in some kind of ectopic beat. Okay, so this is all about the rhythm. Now let us discuss the heart rate. So now regarding the heart rate, so how to calculate the heart rate? How to calculate heart rate by using the ECG? So once we have examined the rhythm, there can be two findings. Either the rhythm is regular or the rhythm is irregular. So either the rhythm can be regular or the rhythm can be irregular. So we have different formulas. We have different formulas for calculating heart rate when the rhythm is regular and when the rhythm is irregular. So first, condition when the rhythm is regular. The formulas, there are two formulas. So the two formulas are, the first formula, heart rate is equal to 300 divided by number of large column between R and R dash. So the first formula is, heart rate is equal to number of large columns or squares between R, R dash. And the second formula is 1500 divided by number of small columns between R and R dash. So the second formula is 1500 divided by number of small columns between R and R dash. So let us see how to calculate that. So here we can see that. So here we can see there are R, R dash, R, R dash, R, R dash and R. Okay. So it is regular. We examine the rhythm. The rhythm is regular. Now we want to calculate the heart rate. So how many number of large columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. As it is regular, it would be equal. So the number of large columns between R, R dash is 4. It is regular. So what would be the heart rate? So according to this example, the heart rate would be 300 divided by 4. And it would be equal to 75. Okay. This is the heart rate. Or you can use 1500 divided by number of small columns between R and R dash. So it would be equal to 1500 divided by, so 4, 5, 20. 20 divided by 1500. It is basically the same. Okay. The heart rate is 75. This is how you calculate the heart rate when the rhythm is regular. So when to use this formula and when to use this formula, when to use the 300 formula and when to use the 1500 formula. So it is usually suggested that if the heart rate is very high or when the heart rate is very low, it is better to use the number of small columns for calculating the heart rate. So when the heart rate is very high or the heart rate is very low, it is better to use the 1500 formula, because the error that comes when the columns are 4.1 or 4.2 would be minimized. Okay, so this is all about calculation of heart rate when the rhythm is regular. Then the second condition, that is when the rhythm is irregular. When the rhythm is irregular, so different methods are there. We will discuss two simple methods. The first method is the average method. This method is called the averaging method. So according to the averaging method, heart rate is equal to 300 multiplied by 3 divided by number of large columns between R and R dash. Between 3 R and R dash. That's the thing. Okay. It's the averaging method. So what does it mean? So in condition where the distance between r and r dash are unequal. Okay, so the distance between r and r dash are unequal. So we basically make an average of three readings. We make an average of first, second, and third. This is what we do, and this is called the averaging method. So here 300 multiplied by 3, number of large columns between r and r dash in three columns, three intervals. Okay, so this is the first method. It is called a simple averaging method. Then the second method. So the second method is called the rhythm strip method or the 10 second method. This method is called the rhythm strip method or the 10 second method. So here the formula is number of R waves. Heart rate is equal to number of R waves in 10 second multiplied by 6. So the formula in the rhythm strip method or 10 second method is number of R waves in 10 second multiplied by 6. So we know what is the what is 10 second in ECG. We have already discussed 1 second is equal to 5 big square and 10 second is equal to 50 big square. So in the rhythm strip, that is in the strip L1, it is looked for in the rhythm strip L1. Number of R waves in 10 seconds is counted and multiplied by 6. That will give you the heart rate. Okay. So this is all about calculating the heart rate and rhythm. So what is its clinical significance of calculating the heart rate and rhythm? What's the clinical significance? So the clinical significance is that we never use ECG to count the heart rate and rhythm. We never use the ECG to count the heart rate and rhythm, isn't it? We simply palpate the peripheral pulsation of the patient. So we never use the ECG to count the heart rate and rhythm. We just do it to get an estimate. So while writing heart rate on ECG reading, simply write down heart rate equal to normal. So while writing the heart rate after measuring the ECG, you simply write down heart rate is equal to heart rate normal. So here heart rate normal does not mean that the heart rate is between 70 to 80. So here writing down heart rate equal to normal does not mean that the heart rate is between 70 to 80. It just means that it is between 60 to 100. Okay. Here we just want to know whether there is sinus tachycardia or sinus bradycardia. So if number of large squares between R and R dash does not touches 3 or 5, we just have to look for that, because 300 divided by 3 is equal to 100 and 300 divided by 5 is equal to 6. So we just want to know whether there is sinus tachycardia or sinus bradycardia. That's what we mean. We don't want the exact count. So if the number of large square is 3, then heart rate is 100. If the number of large squares is 3, then the heart rate is 100. Then we can simply write it down as sinus tachycardia in the heart rate. If the number of large squares is 5, then the heart rate is 60. So we can simply write down sinus bradycardia apart from normal. But the exact heart rate we will count by palpating the peripheral pulse. Okay, plus the rhythm. So clinically in OPD and IPD, just see that the R dash is between 3 to 5 large squares. So in clinics, just see that R to R dash is between 3 to 5 large squares, not touching 3 or less than 3 and not touching 5 or greater than 5 large columns, plus the rhythm. Okay. So this is the clinical utility of reading the heart rate and rhythm in ECG. So this is all about calculating the heart rate and rhythm in ECG and its clinical importance. Thank you.